En dépit de quelques importantes manifestations qui lui ont été consacrées, notamment pour le centenaire de sa naissance, celui de son succès à isoler le fluor, et plus près de nous en 2006, celui de son prix Nobel, Henri Moisan est mal connu, voire inconnu, du plus grand nombre. Voilà qui peut paraître bien étrange si l'on considère le nombre et l'utilité des applications actuelles et en développement de ses multiples travaux, ainsi que l'élan que ses recherches et son enseignement ont donné à la chimie minérale.
His life begins on the 28th of September 1852 at the very end of the Second French Republic, just before the accession of Napoleon III. It is broken by disease on February 1907. Though quite short, it takes place during an important period to French history as far as politics, science, techniques, literature and arts are concerned. Let's give a few examples. Moisson's family has a modest standard of living. His father is an employee at the railways and his mother is a sewer. At the end of the year, 1885, they leave Paris and settle in Meaux, where the young Henry gets used to go to school.
Voilà, donc nous nous trouvons ici au cœur de la.
We are here in the College of Meaux, where the young Moisson has studied between 1864 and 1870.
Lorsqu'il est élève.
He was not in the general section, which was leading to the baccalaureate, but in a parallel one dedicated to the pupils who were to learn a practice as apprentices.
C'est dans ces bâtiments, dans ces murs que Moisson va.
This is also the place where he did make very good friends as the brothers Plick, who will let him get in touch with his future family-in-law.
Les relais qui vont le mettre en contact avec sa future épouse beaucoup plus tard.
It's time we looked at Moisson's works, concentrating ourselves on the fluorine and its byproducts, as well as on the physics and chemistry at very high temperature and pressure.
Le fluor est un élément chimique qui était déjà connu.
After his PhD on iron oxides, Moisson tried to solve a very difficult problem which had mobilized the attention of many chemists during the last 100 years. This was the problem of fluorine isolation. Fluorine was of course already known, but it had never been isolated. Then Moisson set the electrolysis of hydrogen fluoride at low temperature, so it was in a liquid phase, and with potassium fluoride, so the chemical solution was conducting. After several trials, he obtained a gas emission at each electrode, hydrogen on one side and fluorine on the other. This occurred on the 24th of June, 1886. The electric furnace had been known for several decades. Moisson improved it and used it to prepare refractory chemical compounds working on aluminium and iron oxides, as well on calcium carbide. Let's also quote his works on different metals with quite a good purity, chromium, manganese, tungsten, molybdenum, uranium, and of some of their byproducts out of carbon, boron, and silicon. Henri Moisan becomes a member of the Société de Pharmacie de Paris and is to be elected as its president in 1891. He was also a member of the Academy of Science as well as the Academy of Medicine. He was an excellent scientific author, describing his experiments with the same precision as one of his 17th century predecessors, Robert Boyle. Apart from his three theses and a lot of communications, he wrote three important books: The Electric Furnace in 1897, then Fluorine and its Byproducts in 1900, and in the end, The Treatise on Mineral Chemistry in 1905. But Henri Moisan, appointed at the École Supérieure de Pharmacie as a professor for toxicology in 1887, and for a short period for mineral chemistry, then at the Sorbonne as a chairholder for mineral chemistry from 1890 to his death, was also a remarkable teacher according to some of his students who also became great scientists. Let's then listen to a short excerpt of a speech given in 1952 by one of them, Paul Lebeau.
Henri Moisan, grand savant, était aussi un professeur remarquable. Son auditoire était captivé par l'élégance de la parole, par la clarté de l'exposition, par le charme avec lequel il contait les anecdotes instructives qu'il intercalait à propos pour reposer une attention trop longtemps soutenue. Avec lui, la science était toujours aimable.
There's no difficulty to admit that Moisan has been an honnête homme, the way this quality was praised two centuries ago. When he was young, he was fond of humanities, writing poems, and even a play which failed to be staged at the Odéon Theatre. He is known to have gathered an important collection of autographs from the 18th and 19th century, which is unfortunately scattered away nowadays. Good luck, it's not the case for his collection of works of art, some sculptures and many paintings of the time, which was given to the town of Meaux by his only child, Louis, a brilliant chemist, too, killed in front of the enemy at the very beginning of the First World War. Fluorine and its compounds do and will have very important applications in many areas. This will be explained now by representatives of both public and private labs and industrial companies.
A pioneering hospital service, called after Frédéric Joliot-Curie, has been built during the late 50s because, at the time, it was rightfully thought that it was possible to investigate in an automatic way inside the human body using radio elements. Notably, positron emission tomography permits in vivo the three-dimensional detection and quantification of a molecule previously labeled with a short-lived positron-emitting isotope. Such isotopes exist, carbon-11, but also fluorine-18, a radioactive isotope of fluorine-19, isolated by Henri Moisan. Fluorine-18 is an artificial element produced nowadays by biomedical cyclotrons thanks to nuclear transmutation reactions.
We know that Moisan has also been a pioneer in electrometallurgy. Calcium carbide, out of which could be made acetylene, used for lighting, has been the first industrial product to be developed by means of electrometallurgy. Because of a strong competition, industrialists had to find other application with the electric furnace, as iron chromium or iron manganese alloys, and finally iron silicon.
Le ferromanganèse et de fil en aiguille, on en est arrivé jusqu'au ferrosilicium. Cette industrie s'est développée.
This industry settled down first in the Alpine valleys in France because of the hydroelectric power. To be a chemist, or a pharmacist nowadays, is what we are going to deal with now. Teachers, researchers, manufacturers and distributors will testify about their jobs and tell how proud and happy they feel. Teaching, discovering, as Moisson did, manufacturing, serving in those two areas between matter and humanity. Is there anything more exciting for young intelligences if they want to participate to progress? Manage a production facility as Les Claveaux today means producing safely and prepare the site for tomorrow. Then, to answer the question, why young generation must come to science is quite simple. Science is funny. It is also intellectually interesting, and it's useful in our technical jobs as the only way to understand what's going on and to improve our process. To be successful, we do have to keep a permanent eye on the scientific fundamentals we were taught.
Nous avons demandé à quelques-uns des participants à ce documentaire de résumer brièvement ce qu'ils jugent essentiel dans la vie et l'œuvre d'Henri Moisson, qui fut, est et restera un de nos grands scientifiques. Eux, comme nous, espérons l'avoir un peu sorti de la pénombre.
Jean Sandigal de Carbouillère asked me to write the history of carbides in order to build a panel at the 2012 Paris Industry Exhibition. As a consequence, my sister and I knew about the French chemist Henri Moisson, who had made tungsten carbide for the first time. We have realized that there were several similar features between him and our father. For example, chemistry, physics, the building of an electric furnace, and a real passion for innovation.
Teaching chemistry in the only high school called after the first French Nobel Prize in chemistry is actually a great honor for me. Henri Moisson was definitely a great experimenter. As far as I am concerned, I was very fond of experimentation when I was myself a student, and I try now to pass on this passion.
Henri Moisson, pour moi, c'est tout d'abord.
For me, Henri Moisson is one of the most famous figures of this faculty. He founded the Department for High Temperature Chemistry, which has developed here for more than a century. As a matter of fact, we have kept some souvenirs about the life and the works of Henri Moisson, his Nobel Prize diploma, various experiment devices,
son prix Nobel, appareils de laboratoire,
which are now gathered in a small museum, which we hope to enhance soon.
Tous les groupes de recherche travaillant
all the actual teams working on fluorine and on fluoridated products know perfectly what they owe to Henri Moisson. They also definitely know that this famous isolation experience in 1886 has originated great improvements in our daily life.
Ce que je trouve fascinant dans la vie de Moisson,
what is so exciting about Moisson's life? I believe it's his career, starting by a clockwork apprenticeship and ending by the Nobel Prize. Nothing of the sort would have been possible without the second-class diploma, which was all the same beneficial to other scientists of the time, such as Behal. Could this kind of social and intellectual advancement be possible today? What is so essential and so modern in Henri Moisson's discoveries? Let's just think of those old fluorides, which today are looked at in a new way, for example, as transparent ceramics and no more as single crystals. This is really impressive when we consider our present researchers. I would like to conclude by saying that, in my opinion, Moisson is a great physical chemist, because he did use the emerging theories of his time and applied them to solve some very important problems in chemistry.
Le prix Henri Moisson.
The Henri Moisson Prize was established in 1986 on the occasion of the International Symposium held in Paris, which somehow celebrated the isolation of fluorine successfully done by Henri Moisson 100 years ago. This prestigious reward is given every 3 years to a scientist who has remarkably worked on fluorine chemistry and thus perpetuated Moisson's heritage.